Our first speaker is a powerful Zapotec mujer, co-founder of CIELO, which stands for Comunidades Indígenas en Liderazgo. She will be leading us through a moment of Conexión and Reconocimiento, a conversation after is going to follow where we're going to learn about her mission and how we can further support Comunidades Indígenas. Now, I'm excited to welcome Odilia Romero to the stage. Muchas gracias, Odilia, for joining us.
Muchas gracias.
Muchas gracias.
Por compartir este momento sagrado.
Padir figure, abajire. Can you repeat after me now? Padir figure, abajire. Yugure nure, junen shin. Chakrene bene. I know, right? It's a tongue twister. We'll leave that at that. As someone that was displaced from her land, I acknowledge this land that receives me in the territory where the Coahuila tribe lives. We salute the existence of indigenous communities that have lived in this territory for thousands of years. For us, the Zapotec, it is important to feed the land and give thanks to the earth for letting us walk in her belly button. That is why we offer a zip of mezcal and a bit of tortilla. As a displaced woman from Oaxaca, I thank the Coahuila relative for letting me be on this unceded land across an imposed border, where I have made a family. But I must say, that worries me that my Coahuila sisters are not here today, and they're just a few blocks from here. It fills me with joy to participate in this event. We indigenous people have worked, especially women, to create visibility of our existence as indigenous peoples. We salute this event where the nations come together and hold hands, because holding hands is not taking a step back. It is a way to come closer to the same space, a way of being together and contributing to build a fairer world. Recently, I saw a post on Twitter. It stated that one-fourth of the 1.8 million people incarcerated in this country identify as Latinos. I could not help to wonder how many of them were indigenous. We don't know, because there's an assumption that we're all Latinos, and I'm not. I'm in solidarity with your cause, but I'm Zapotec. I'm Benerfron, Beneyayew, Benerfrusho. That's who I am in my language. And we won't be able to know as long as the institutions in charge won't break the figures to specify the languages of incarcerated people. A lot of questions come to mind. What percentage of these indigenous people were in prison for not having a due process in their language? How many of them were sentenced because their right to interpret was not guaranteed? How does the U.S. justice system ensure that people understand and make themselves understood in a court proceeding? And how many indigenous people convicted for a crime that they did not commit? The only crime is crossing a border. It is important that we all work together to tackle language violence against indigenous people. For us, wearing a huipil on Mexican Independence Day on September 16 is not solidarity. In fact, wearing a huipil could mean intellectual property spoliation for indigenous community. People talking about us on social media is very important, but the really essential is knowing how you are fighting against language violence in your places of work and profession, and how your actions contribute to stopping this high-intensity war against indigenous populations. Lots of people praise and promote mezcal. Who hasn't had mezcal? We all have. I have it often. But it's a ceremonial beverage for us. But we fail to tend to the water crisis and land spoliations that come from the agave exploitation. Both are root cause of displacement of indigenous communities that have to migrate and face being criminalized and incarcerated. What we want from you today, Chingonas, is we want your solidarity to fight and stop the war against indigenous people. Colonization isn't over. It continues in the appropriation of our food, our drinks, our regalia. For us, wearing a huipil is an act of resistance because we suffer racism when we dress in our traditional clothing. Although we wear them with pride and joy, the same way we enjoy our food and drinks that have sustained us for centuries, for us it's alarming that our culture is seen as a commercial purpose. People like our products, but they don't like us. They like everything about us, but they don't like us. There's a lot of ways to pay respect and support indigenous people's culture. If you're going to buy a huipil, it is important that you know the history and the place where it was made. The huipil I'm wearing today was made by a Chatina woman from Santiago Yaitepec. Anybody knows about the Virgen de Juquila? No. If you all believe in virgenes, she's a must go to. She's the Oaxacan virgin. So, in the 1970s, this town, the Chatina woman fought the causes in defense of the woods and territory and the felling of trees. The landowners killed several men and women, but the community continued to resist until today. Today, this community is constantly being threatened by hotel companies to seek to displace them. This is the town where the women, the way my huipil. So if you're all wearing a huipil, learn the history, the struggle, her story, and her land defense story, and share it. Because your platform as Chingona women is very powerful, and you could use it to join us in resistance. You can also support indigenous communities on your workplace. You are doctors, healthcare experts, lawyers, escritoras, chingonas, cabronas, you know, that you can provide service to indigenous people in their languages in your workplace. Indigenous communities are scattered all around the U.S., no matter if you're in New York, in New Jersey, Nebraska, Indiana, you're gonna find indigenous people. And know that we will always be organized and practicing what the Zapotecs call Gelaguetza, an organizational system used for preparing food and making arrangements for celebrations and funerals. In Quiche, the word is Koshkol, in Ishil, Munil, and in Aymara is called Aini. So everywhere we go, we continue to practice our traditions. The stories behind indigenous communities' displacements are often heartbreaking. They are the opposite of what the narrative about the American dream tells us. We left our territories because of spoliation. Nobody risks leaving behind their crops, their rivers, their art, and come to a place where nobody speaks their language. For us, solidarity is taking all this into context and consideration. This is why today is important for us to stand up. Can we all stand up? Now let's hold our hands like good chingonas. Okay, we all hold hands. And together, we commit to walking in solidarity with indigenous peoples. Right? Do I hear si se puede?
Si se puede.
Si se puede louder?
Si se puede.
And this is a cause of joy. Jerf grande yugure. All right. Okay. So I did that exercise to share how different our language is from Spanish. Do you all want to know what I said? We'll figure it out right now.
Gracias, Odilia. Give it up for Odilia.
nos sentamos.
Okay. Yeah.
Ya, aquí estamos ya más a gusto.
Yeah.
Más en confianza. Thank you so much for sharing such a sacred moment con nosotras y también such powerful information. Y también pues enseñando que estamos conectadas, estamos conectadas. Y mientras estás aquí, I felt your power y también tu alegría, the power of your joy. What are some of the practices that you do that help you stay centered in that joy and stay centered in your power?
What are some practices? Well, I curse a lot, half of the time.
Eso!
and then I bike. I learned how to bike at 51, ladies, so it's never too late. So every year I'm learning something that I was not able to do as a child. Last year I learned to swim at 50.
Wow, yes.
So I'm doing things that I was not allowed to do as a child, didn't have the privilege to have. So that's what I'm doing to stay centered.
Eso. So you're like reclaiming and loving that inner niña, that baby Odilia, que le estás dando como esa oportunidad de renacer o de salir.
Yes, definitely.
To bring out that inner joy and also to curse. There's something that's very healing. De decir.
And I have a lot of mezcal too. No?
You have what?
I drink a lot of mezcal, of course.
Saludcita, saludcita.
Saludcita, you know?
I know. There's a saying del pa tequila. No, algo como para mezcal también. Oh, para todo mal, mezcal.
Y para todo, todo bien, bien también.
También. So, tell me something for you. What does joy mean to you?
Well, joy is, one, is speaking my language. I think I could express joy a lot better in my language. But I think joy is like creating these spaces, right? It brings me a lot of joy to see that there's an Indigenous woman speaking here today. We have gone a long way, and I really appreciate Anna's solidarity and all that we all grow team, because this is her story in the making, you know?
Claro.
Yeah.
Claro. So. Representing y mantenernos conectadas like with the essence of who we are and what's made us who we are. And part of that too is like, I want to know more about that. I mean, like the path that led you to create Cielo and the path that led you to be who you are today. Y hace que pues es muchas historias, pero que es algo that you want us to take with you, that you've walked along. How can we walk alongside with you?
I think in Indigenous communities, and I'm sure in a lot of Latino communities, you work with family, and you always create with your family, your sisters, and one of the things that for us is so important and brings us a lot of joy is that Cielo exists. Mm-hmm. And I co-founded it with my daughter, who is in the audience. Where is she? She's wearing a yellow huipil. Janet, where are you? I'm gonna put her on the spot. But it's that, right? That's, mm-hmm. And we created Cielo because there was a need to create an Indigenous woman-led organization that focuses and centers Indigenous women, but especially young Indigenous women. And today I have like this beautiful, smart, chingona women, Quiche, Acateco, that are here, you know, Aurora, Gladys, Genesis, they're all Mayans. You know, the Mayans are popular nowadays, you know. but that brings me a lot of joy, and they needed to be a space specifically for Indigenous women and that advocates for Indigenous people's rights and for people to know that we exist today and we exist across the U.S., in Mexico. Does anybody know how many languages are spoken in Mexico? There are 68 Indigenous language families, but there's over 364 Indigenous languages spoken. Wow, I know. And anybody know how many are spoken in Guatemala? All right. Over 22 Indigenous languages plus Garifuna, and of course Spanish. Yeah, and if we go across the whole continent, you will know that our continent's very diverse and so many languages are spoken.
So rich in language, so rich in culture, y también lo que estoy viendo, so rich in that intergenerational healing que estás haciendo. I feel like when we're building that connection between generations, it's como una trenza. It's like a braid that it's only making us stronger because we're weaving together the generations that came before us, the present and the future, porque nos necesitamos. And I think it's so beautiful that you're bringing that into your reality and to our reality by having your daughter be a part of such an important process.
Yeah, so she's been walking with me since she was probably 14, and I remember her making poster, and she's like, you know this is child labor, right? And I'm like, uh-huh, and, you know? But she's been an activist since she was a young kid, and now we're leading CIELO together, creating this visibility, and also educating institutions about the existence of indigenous people. So together and with an amazing team of chingonas, young people, young Mayans, Zapotecs, that are part of CIELO.
Claro. And speaking of a comunidad de chingonas, aquí tenemos una. How can we join you? How can we join you in that mission? How can we support CIELO? ¿Qué necesitamos hacer?
Well, you guys are so powerful and popular. Grab your phone right now.
Do it.
Everybody grab your phone. Go to your Instagram account and follow mycielo_.org. Share our work, share our post. You never know who watches you and who donates to indigenous people. It doesn't have to always be money, right? Share our work. Through your platform, you could create visibility of indigenous people. That's one way of solidarity. Did our followers increase now, Janet, somewhere out there?
A ver si están obedeciendo. So visibility. Awareness,
and sharing your space. You know, the Latino movement is very important, and we would never ask you to step back, right? Because your struggle is very important. But hey, like back home, en un carrito caben cinco, puede caber uno más. Apretaditos,
más calientitos.
Apretaditos, we'll go a long way. Right? You learn from our culture, we learn from your culture. Apretaditos, we could go very far together in fighting for justice for migrants, from the Latino migrants. We have to stop this criminalization of our communities, but also in that carrito, you know, nos vamos en el guajolotero todos, and we fight. And we fight together like good chingonas, you know?
Eso. And I love how you said en ese carrito porque me pasó eso. I was in, I was like waiting for a taxi. Yo ya estaba como media impaciente. I was like a little like impatient. I was like, come on, I called this taxi a long time ago. Me dijo, en un ratito llego. Era un ratote. And then they got there and there was already people in the taxi. And I was like, this is my taxi. Why are they in there? And they were like so calm. They looked at me. They're like, todos cabemos. Like, we all fit here. Why are you all up in, you know, like, they're like, relájate, todos cabemos y caben más. And I'm like, me callaron la boca. En el carrito cabemos y vamos más lejos.
Apretaditos, pero
apretaditos.
Cabemos.
Apretaditos. Es más rico la vida apretadita, you know? So I'm like, I don't want, so I'm like, the message of today is apretaditos. Es más rico. No me hagan caso en eso. Odilia. What is the message that you would like for us, people here and people at home watching? Like, what is something that you would like for us to take away today?
I think one thing that you have to have in the back of your mind always, that not everybody speaks Spanish.
No, es cierto.
That no one, not every single person in Latin America speaks Spanish, that there are many of us that our first language is an indigenous language. You know, if you go to New York, they have the largest diversity of languages with a smaller population. If you come to California, we have the largest populations of indigenous languages, right? So know that everywhere you go, si se ven prietitos como yo, not everybody speaks Spanish. Think about it twice. If you're a doctor, an attorney, a nurse, a writer, or whatever profession you have, always keep in mind that that person that you're talking to might not be understanding, might not be responding because of a language barrier. Let's end this language violence together, and you are at the forefront. Because if you're a doctor, if you're an attorney, if you're a social worker, you're gonna encounter us. We are all over the place, and one thing that we need to do too is change the narrative. Help us change the narrative. And include indigenous people of this land in the conversation. Those are the things that we could do together. Oh, what is it? Oh, my cielo underscore O-R-G. And that's Janet.
We see you, Janet. Change the narrative. Apretaditos, vamos más lejos. My cielo underscore O-R-G. Y gracias por ser un ejemplo de una mujer guerrera. Thank you for being an example of a guerrera, of a mujer, a warrior woman that is building intergenerational healing. And when we build intergenerational healing, that's intergenerational wealth. We are changing the narrative when we speak up and when we create these movements. So muchísimas gracias, Odilia.
Gracias. And if you're wondering what you said or what I told you in Zapotec,
yes,
I say, are you all sitting there? Because there's no way to say hello. Are you all sitting there, women that lead your work spaces? Because there's no way to say chingona, and there's no way to say lideresa. Mm. Right? It's so different. It's very poetic, my language.
Hey.
Thank you, ladies. Gracias. Jorge Krenle, and that means thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you, Kim. Jorge Krenle.
Jorge Krenle.
Le.
Le.
Yeah, Jorge Krenle.
Muchas gracias.
Gracias.
Gracias, Olivia.
Thank you. Thank you, ladies.